again, Brother.
Shalom, Marit.
So, wanna color the...
Yes.
Design?
This is my design, and I've never worked with aquarelle colored pencils before. So, Arita is going to show me how to
use a brush with some water and go over the coloring. It's really easy. What you have to do is dip your brush in some water, wipe the extra water off the brush, and then you have to decide which one where you're going to start. And my tip is to start with the bright colors first. So in your design, I would start with the yellow. So going over the yellow. And how I do it, Doda, I go over the outlines first. So I put boundaries around the shape I'm going to color, and then I color the inside. Can you see the difference, Doda, in the coloring after you add the water?
The water, it perks it up. It gives it some nice intensity.
Yes, making the color more alive.
Yes, more vivid.
More vivid, and
when I colored on this hard surface, there were little white spots.
Right.
And it gets rid of that.
Yes. More consistent. Yes.
Definitely.
And I also like the feeling of it. I like the brush feeling when I color with it. It's very, very relaxing and calming down. And that's all I think about when I brush, when I use the brush with the colors.
So I have a question about this technique, and that is, if I miss something in my coloring and I'm brushing it with the water, can I go back when this is dry and add more color and then brush it again?
Yes, Dora. You can do this. You can mix color with the aquarelle pencils. Even though you finished coloring with them, you can brush in with water and color with the brush. Mm-hmm. You can go back and add more colors.
Oh, all right, so it gives you a lot of flexibility.
Yes, a lot of freedom.
Well, we like freedom.
We love freedom. We love choices. We love new ideas. Brainstorming. We just finished a nice business meeting that we talked about new ideas. And thank you, Doda.
Oh, my pleasure.
I love your ideas.
Well, we sync very well.
Very well.
Yes.
Very well. Very lucky and blessed.
All right, so I have another question. I finished my yellow Seed of Life design, and I'm wondering if you have a recommendation on what to do next.
Well, basically, I'm starting the technique I'm using. I'm starting from the center, and then I go out.
Okay.
So
do I have to let the yellow dry?
No. You can continue coloring, because you're not going to color the yellow, you're going to color the blue.
Alright, so I'll start on the blue.
Do you like how it feels, Doda, when you color with the brush?
Well, it's interesting. It's more precise you color with the pencils first and then brush it, then it would be, for me, if I tried painting.
Right.
So there's a lot more control this way.
Yes. Yes, I know what you mean. I like it too very much.
So do you ever do any of your coloring designs with regular coloring pencils, not aquarelles?
I have always used aquarelle because I like this option that I can go back and brush it with the water and then make the colors more vivid and live. It's something, and I also like to hold the brush. I love this feeling. And so I'm used to them, I love them, and
they always work for you.
Yes, they work well for me. And I would like to thank you for bringing the new set of 48 new coloring pencils. Thank you, Doda, for shipping them in your suitcase.
You're welcome.
With yourself. To Israel, to the gallery.
I came with colored pencils,
yes. And you know, I'm very excited when I get a new set. And this time I chose to wait with opening the new set because, you know, I want to do a review video on the set. And I was thinking that I'll tell you what I thought to talk about while doing the review. And of course, I would love to hear what you say and what ideas you have about this video. So, first of all, I thought about saying hello and what my name is and the business, of course, Hallelujah Jewish Solar. And I thought that I should say that today I'm going to do a review on my new set of 48 aquarelle coloring pencils, and then I would thank my Doda for bringing them. And then I thought about saying where I bought them and the price. And you know, the case is with nylon, so I will start unwrapping the set and showing the case and the drawers. It has four drawers. This set with the pencils, and maybe read about a little bit from the brochure they give. Something that the company writes about, and you know, it's the third time I'm buying this this brand.
Wow.
It's a good brand. I think, how would you pronounce it, Doda? It's written on the surface. It's a Brunziel. Brunziel? Can you spell it for me, Doda? Can you read it?
Brunziel.
How would you pronounce it, Doda?
I have no idea.
I would say Brunziel.
That sounds good.
Okay, this is a company from the Netherlands that produces coloring pencils, pastels, all kinds of pencils, and it's a very good company, and it also has another name beside it, and it's a sakura. And what I heard that sakura is a Japanese name, and it's in the Netherlands, but it also has a Japanese ownership.
Oh my!
Yes. So I don't know, Netherlands and Japan sound so good.
Well,
sounds like a very high quality product, and the fact that I'm buying it for the third time definitely states that I really, really like these coloring pencils.
Have you ever used any other materials to color your coloring pages?
Besides
the aquarelles?
I'm so in love with the aquarelle pencils. These are my favorite. Actually, a few days ago, I opened some colors I bought like 20 years ago while I was a student in the States. And these are not pencils, it's some kind of other colors. And I love them as well because I color with them. It has like how do you say it in English? Chalks?
Coloring chalks.
Yes, but for artists. And what I like about it is the option that after I color, I can take my finger and smudge it. Yes. But this is a very different effect than the pencils, of course. But it's also something I might explore more with my coloring pages in the future. And what did you think about the how I laid the video, the structure of the preview video?
I'm not clear what we're talking about. Honey.
Okay, you remember?
Try me again.
Yes, I will do that. Remember, I told you I want to do a preview on the new set, and then I started telling you what I want to do in the video. And then we continue talking about other things, but
you got off. Can you refresh me, please?
Yes. So, shalom, my name and business. Today I'm going to review, and then I'm going to show the set and start to unpack it from the nylons, and talking about a set of 48 coloring pencils. Saying thank you to my daughter, where did they get it, the price, talking about the drawers with the, taking out the drawers with the coloring pencils, reading a little bit from the company's brochure, and talking about the colors, how the variety of colors, and the fact that it's actually the third time that I'm buying this brand, and
I would be interested if I were watching. I think, do you use them for anything other than your coloring pages? Have you used them for other crafts, or have your children used them?
I let my children use them, but basically I buy these for coloring the designs, the coloring pages. Then I photograph the coloring pages, and I upload it to the website where I sell them, and I show people how it looks when it's colored.
All right, and if people are interested in your art and they don't want to color the mandalas themselves. Are there, or do you have plans to sell any of your designs that are already colored?
Colored coloring pages?
If not, coloring pages, yes, color that
are already colored.
Are already colored or that already have colors in the designs.
Okay, so there are two things. They are selling the coloring pages, which I color by myself, or selling a design that I colored in the program which I used to design it, and then sell it as a print. As a colored print. And I have a few prints that are already colored that people can download online from my Etsy shop. Look for Zebra Toys, www.zebratoys.etsy.com. You have a special tab with prints.
All right, because not everybody may feel called to color, but the designs are so beautiful.
Thank you, Donna.
Well, you
Thank
know.
Thank you for bringing this up.
Yes, and people fall in love with the designs.
Thank you, Donna.
You're welcome, honey.
So, any other tips you might have for the video?
I think what interests people is story.
Mm.
So when you talk about how this is the third time you've bought the Aquarelles coloring set, you might want to share a little bit about the evolution of your business and you know, your continuing love of this product, because it seems to me that they kind of go hand in hand. And I know I'm always interested in story because it helps me make a connection with the person who's telling the story, and also a connection with what's going on in my life that also may help me connect.
Very nice, Donna. I like this point. Story is definitely a thing that I should be more focused on. The story I have here is to actually take out the coloring, the new coloring pencils, take out one of my new designs of a coloring page with the sacred geometry and the Jewish solar, and coloring, and talk about how it makes me, like, first of all, say how does it feel when I actually color with them,
right?
And then move from this point to how it's how it makes me feel inside me when I color.
Oh, lovely, lovely. I like that, and I think that will help whoever is watching the video to connect with you and the Aquarelles and also your coloring pages.
Nice.
Yeah. So it goes full circle.
Thank you, Mama.
Yeah, very nice.
Thank you. So, do you think this is structure, the video structure we talk about, can be a basic preview for other products I want to preview?
Yeah,
like you brought me another set of coloring pens that have the brushes and. These are water-based pens with brushes at the end. And do you think I can reuse this, or do you think I should go and do it differently?
You You know, I like an outline. You know, bodies have skeletons, right? Skeletons are pretty much the same, but we all look different. You know, so I think a skeleton is good, and the story you tell about the pencils with the brushes will be a different story than the story you tell about the aqua elves.
Because
you've had a different experience with them.
Okay.
And yes.
So maybe make the main structure, but change the story.
Well, the story will keep, yes, because it will be different for every product that you review. And I think people are interested in your story as much as they're interested in the products.
Right. Thank you. Sharing this, maybe I
can. You're welcome, honey.
I love the color selection you picked for them.
Oh, thank you. I like the rainbow colors. When I was a little girl in art, which is many years ago, we had paint boxes with, they were called praying. I don't know if you have them in Israel, watercolors. They were the same colors of the rainbow, the primary, red, yellow, blue, the secondary, orange, green, purple. Then they had brown and black. So I grew up with these colors.
So it takes you back to childhood and to art classes.
Yeah, it takes me back many years to when I was a girl. And so it's I loved art.
Nice.
Yeah, I did. So it's nice that it continues in the family. So are these special brushes that we're using, right?
Well, these brushes we're using originally are sold online on AliExpress as brushes for designing small, tiny designs on nails?
Oh, for nails?
Yes. For
oh,
that.
My gracious.
Yes.
So these are manicurist brushes.
For drawing on nails,
oh my
small
gracious.
Designs. This is why they're designed like this.
Yeah.
I love them very much because they can... I can be more precise with them. And when I want a person to color, to feel the shapes easily, if I choose to. So it's two benefits that make me like them so much. And I also like the way they feel when I hold them.
Yes, they're very easy to work with.
Yes.
All right, so is there any benefit to coloring the lighter colors first and then the darker colors, or it really doesn't matter?
I think it matters because, first of all, if you're using the same water, it's better to use the bright color to color, start with the clean water, color the bright colors, and then move to the darkest ones.
Okay.
So it won't blend and ruin the bright colors. And the second thing that make me do that is when I start with the dark colors, sometimes I'm not precise enough, and it move and it colors the bright colors over the bright. And for some reason, when I start with the bright color, it happens less.
Okay.
So I see that you haven't colored the blue yet.
Look. Oh, I did.
You did?
I did color the blue.
Are you sure you did that?
That was a little dark. Yes, I colored the blue. I don't know why. I may have to color it again.
Maybe, because it doesn't, you know,
it doesn't look colored.
And it's a beautiful mandala you're coloring with that.
Thank you, honey.
It's, I like your color selection. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
And here is mine, the flower of life. So much fun, Loda.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Thank you for inviting me over for a coloring party.
My pleasure, Toda. I enjoyed it so much. And I'm going to, I already miss you. And I'm going to miss you even more when you leave tomorrow. So I want to wish you a good time in France. And have a nice trip back home.
Okay.
And I'll wait patiently for our next Skype meeting.
Okay, very good. And we hope you've enjoyed our coloring party as much as we have.
Yes, thank you for joining us. Okay, goodbye.
This is how our read always ends. She says, shalom, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
That was fun.
Much fun, as usual.
Very fun.
So lucky.